Hello, this everyone.
Is... Purger
of the perverted this is what? Paladin.
How are you not... Die! Lord! Anyways, hello,
this
everyone.
This is part die of Overlord.
Yeah, I don't know. It's like... I don't know. There's only been like 9 episodes. Oops, I didn't mean to kick you. Wanted to kick the fool. Anyways, yeah, welcome back. What were we doing again? Find the entrance to the Dwarven Lands. Search for and destroy Oberon's root nose and kill Oberon. Okay, cool. Now that we have those objectives, let's go do them. Where the hell was I?
Oh boy.
Skull Den, that doesn't sound familiar. We were in Evernight, but that'll send us back like super far. Fuck it, Skull Den. Because I don't remember Skull Den in the last episode.
Do you want to just pull up the last video you did to see?
No, fuck it. It'll take too long. Oh, wait. Oh, right! I forgot to grab the mana thing off screen. Fuck. No, do you remember?
Barely. I just...
It involved me raging. I figured you'd remember. Damn it. Why? Why? Why do you make hostile creeps like that? Their only purpose is to give me more minions, and yet they're hostile for no discernible reason. Oh wow, that was weird. Oh jeez, why is my game jumping? I must be getting near something important. Okay, where's my minions? Seriously. Maybe they're right outside. So what even happened last time, do you remember?
I know that you got really salty, but then again,
yeah,
that happens.
That always happens, and it wasn't my fault. Fuck you. Oh, I guess I'm going in there with nothing but green minions. Because this game had the amazing foresight to forget to give me things. Brother's playing For Honor. I don't own the game because it's $60.
Speaking of $60, there are people defending Mass Effect Andromeda.
I have seen none of that.
Of Mass Effect Andromeda or people defending the game?
People defending the damn game. I've seen
a bunch of
shit on it.
Simon's the only person I actually see defending it, because even the people giving it positive reviews are like, oh, come on, guys, it's Babby's first game, give it a chance.
Yeah, no, it's like they're just using the BioWare name to actually sell the game. They're not actually making, you know, a good game.
Like Konami?
Yeah, basically Konami took our... Seriously, why is my game being choppy? This is bad.
It's times like this where I wish Discord had screen share.
Oh, yeah.
Then again, that might actually happen by the time this comes out.
Some people would be wondering, what did you use all that time? Skype? Well, as a matter of fact, yes. And it's awful.
Never use it, kids.
You know what, I understand this video is going to come out in like 3 months, but fuck it, let's talk about how awful everything about Andromeda is.
Oh my god. Trust me, this game is going to be... I would not be surprised if this ends up on like worst games ever made list, based on everything I've seen.
Yeah, no, and it's... My brother was like, hey, let's not knock it until we give it a shot, and I'm like, Are you sure?
I mean... Normally, I would say, let's give it a chance, but we've seen 2 years of shit at this point.
Yeah, no, what's it called?
I mean, it's not like No Man's Sky where it looked promising until you actually played the game. There's no promise at all.
Yeah. Please get away. Okay.
So if there's anything good about Mass Effect Andromeda, is that it at least is that there was at least some warning that it was gonna be crap.
Yeah, no, there was just there was just one scene that really fucking bothered me. Because it could have been done so much better with less effort, mind you.
My Maya skills absolutely suck. But even I can do better than some of the animations I've seen.
Yeah, no, it's like that. Did you see that picture I retweeted on Twitter with the glass of water?
You mean where she pours a glass of jelly and then touches it up against her lips?
No, it's like if you have a cutting enough eye, you can see that the liquid doesn't even come out of the damn cup. It has no momentum anywhere except downwards, which is where gravity's pulling it.
If and like the, somebody can, made that where I got my degree, they would have failed.
Oh yeah. How do I use fire again? I want to use fire.
Just rub two sticks together and almost.
No.
Yes, master.
There we go. Okay. Now, please, please don't break the pathfinding. It's really not that hard. Like, I actually studied on pathfinding tips, and I
and
have no.
And today on Twitter, I actually said that if you could buy Breath of the Wild with no console to play it on, and it would be a better investment than MEA.
Yeah, but that's because Breath of the Wild, like, it's the promise of a good game once you buy a console. For Mass Effect...
Exactly, like, you could say that you have a good game, you just can't play it.
Yeah. What's it called? Yeah, no, the water, that just shot where she pours the liquid, you don't even need to have that. If you wanted it, you could do it in a way where you don't have to render any liquid at all. Because that scene was fucking horrible, and I honestly think that it would have been a bit more interesting if they didn't. Like, they could even use the sci-fi setting to justify not ever showing it. Like, she just sticks a cup in some future machine, walks away, grabs the pad, comes back to the machine, and the machine has a full glass of jelly or whatever.
Even in death.
Alternatively,
statue.
You could just shot it from an angle where you don't actually see any of the liquid, and that would have also been fine. It makes me wonder what the hell were you thinking?
Apparently, the lead animator wasn't even an animator, but a cosplayer.
Yeah, no, she was like 24 years old or something. I heard it was something or some... Like, someone was... Or the crowd was blaming
you've
someone.
Probably seen it, but you know that picture where it's like... Where it's like $15 million and of Slavic technology and flint and stones.
Yeah.
And it's Witcher 3, and then on the right it's like $60 million created by Dr. Frankenprivilege.
Yeah. No, and
could you please put that up for the viewers to see just in case?
Alright. But what's it called? A more modern comparison is what's it called? The new Berserk remake versus the no, not the new Berserk remake. What's like a sweatshop anime? Because if you compare that,
all of them?
No. There's a few good ones. Like even if you absolutely despise anime, you can see production quality in some of them. What's it called? I guess any A1 Pictures. I'm with Digibro on this one. Every A1 Pictures.
I don't know, this seems like something I have soul would know.
Maybe, yeah. No, it's like, I swear, everything that A1 Pictures put out that I have seen, like Seven Deadly Sins, was just absolutely awful when I dropped it pretty much like two or three episodes in. I tried to give it a chance, but it fucking... But, like,
you watched
and then,
the subs, right?
I watched both, and neither of them made it better.
Huh.
It was it's just everything, it wasn't just the acting. The story was
Let's just talk about.
Like,
can we talk about good anime that we've seen, like just in general?
What's one that I've seen recently? Because I don't want to just talk about good anime that's been out for years.
Well, I wasn't gonna go like. Well, I was gonna talk about Cromarty High School.
Yeah, okay. That is a good one, though.
Probably the only time I would recommend watching the dub of something.
Well, I mean, dubs aren't bad. Like, a lot of dubs aren't bad. Like, if you watch the Dragon Ball Z sub, it's fucking awful and actually kind of hilarious.
Actually, speaking of Dragon Ball Z, did you see that video where they get Goku and Vegeta to do that scene from Step Brothers?
No, that would have been awesome.
Oh, they do the scene where the two brothers finally like each other.
Oh yeah.
They realize how much they have in common.
Yeah, no, I never watched Step Brothers, but I am familiar with.
Oh my god, you need to! No, you need to. It's absolutely hilarious.
I bet you it is.
Favorite non-pornographic magazine to masturbate to. Good Housekeeping.
Okay.
Because the whole movie is about these two stay-at-home. It's about these two guys who live with their single parents, and they're both super losers.
Yeah, they're neats. We have a term for that in the nerd community.
Neats. I've never actually heard that term until I saw that one Sorgum video.
Really? It's been around for a while.
Yeah, I never heard of that term until when Sargon used it in one of his videos.
Yeah, no, it's a pretty common term.
Well, now I know about it and I love it.
I mean, yeah. I could swear I can run across the. Oh, come on. Can they stop spawning creeps everywhere, especially ones that kill the minions when they fast? I completely forgot what it was. Stop it! Blues! You choose all! Can we please stop it with these giant beetle things? At least not make them respawn. This isn't fun. I'm just trying to figure out what the fuck to do. But, okay, good anime that I have seen recently. Does Samurai Jack count? No? Is that a bad one? Okay. You're not paying attention anymore, are you?
What?
Yeah, figured. Oh, that's a thing. How did I miss the thing? I want the thing. Go get the thing. Probably. No, not that thing. Grab the thing. A new shield spell, Lord. So what are you doing right now? Cool. Sounds pretty awesome.
Are you just having a conversation with yourself now?
Well, I was trying to have a conversation with you, but apparently my social skills are so bad I can't even get your attention.
I'm sorry, what was that, Jake?
Love you too. You know, hanging out with theater people has been an enlightening experience. And also, I am just realizing how oblivious I am to drama.
Well, shield yourself from oncoming enemies. It's got a bit of a kick to it too, which will send them flying.
Okay, cool. I'll just let you do your thing then. Well, I go on about how oblivious I am to social cues. Especially ones...
Drama people?
Huh? Well, yeah, theater people, actors. And how...
My sister's in theater.
Yeah. But, yeah. I don't know. I always feel kind of juvenile when I hang out with him. Not for any reason in particular, just because, like, I just miss a whole bunch of... social cues at times, and, like, conversational beats. And then I just completely freeze up because I don't know what I'm doing. I just kind of, you know, wander to the back. And also, I'm completely oblivious to all the drama that's happening. Like, none of this would have been... I wouldn't even known about half the drama that happens if it wasn't from my friends just, like, actually informing me on this shit.
I don't know, like me, I was in the camp that never really heard any of it because I didn't really care.
Yeah, no, it's like, I don't pry, I don't really care. But, like, this is... apparently, the shit that's been going on behind my back is, like, Spanish soap opera level. Like, this shouldn't be happening. Kind of like the Korean political storm. Can we just kill the damn thing? Thank you.
Is that, like, the incandescent flint beetles?
Kind of. They're what gives me minion souls.
So without those, your minions turn into Jake?
No, I just don't have minions. Okay, I already claimed that.
You didn't get the joke I just made, do you?
Yeah, they turn into soulless ginger, sure. Can we stop killing my minions? Please, I just want to get from point A to point B. I don't give a fuck. I don't know what I'm doing. I'm probably just gonna jump on all of this.
For the Overlord.
Oh, I forgot about
that. Lose!
Don't tell me I'm supposed to go to this section with just three minions. Hi, please don't. Don't know what you were planning, don't want to know what you were planning, stop it. Oh, this is gonna take fucking time. You three aren't even doing anything. Alright. Now off to do something else.
So I think I told you earlier that me and Jake went through Thomas Was Alone.
Wait. Who was alone?
Well, Jake, but also Thomas.
Thomas Was Alone. I've heard of that, don't really know much about it.
It's basically a story about squares.
Oh my, come on! Give me stop that! I just wanna do the thing and finish the quest. I'm gonna have to kill Oberon now. Funny, the thing we're doing as a character.
King Elmo?
King Oberon. What's it called? The theater thing that I'm doing with the theater people.
What's the play called?
Never mind, don't worry about it. Okay, seriously, how do I get my minions over here? Because I don't want to do this with blue minions. I know how much I detest them, because they're the weakest species.
They are the inferior race of minions.
In this case, yeah, all they do is a support. Like, they legit do nothing besides support. And also resist magic for some dumb reason.
Yeah.
Yeah, so you never answered my question. What the hell are you doing?
Oh, I was looking up how to get the next thing to do in Zelda Wind Waker.
I don't know why, I just expect you to be on the quickly looking up random Sonichu facts.
No, I did that. I did all of that before we even started the series.
Yeah, no, I started looking up stuff just out of curiosity, and then, like, some of
it... And then you got sucked into the black hole that is Christian Weston Chandler.
Yeah, no, it's like... I don't know, it's so weird, because I actually have an autistic friend. He has Asperger's, but,
I think we should mention right now that if there's anybody watching this with autism, there's a 99.9% chance that you will not end up like Chris. Chris?
Oh, yeah.
What happened with Chris most likely will never happen to anyone else. What happened to Chris is that it's a big amount of circumstances and events that... Basically, if anything else happened in Chris's life, we would not have... the amazing thing he is today.
Oh dear god, you want me to rush the killer unicorns. Oh fuck you, I'm coming back for this shit.
In fact, the second episode, which I uploaded at the time we're recording this, I actually go over Chris's childhood.
Yeah, that... I like how everyone on the quickie just calls him Borb. The parents, Barb and...
Oh. Bob.
Yeah, no, okay.
I've seen them call the mother Snorlax.
That one's interesting. Yeah, no, it...
Which, if you've ever seen pictures of Barb, she looks a lot like a Snorlax does.
As mean as that is, I can't disagree. All the way so I can tell you all later. Oh my god, are you serious?
And there's the salt!
This is fucking bullshit! Why would you...
This is glorious!
I didn't command them to die, I commanded them to go back in the burrow. They've killed themselves out of their own free will. Which they shouldn't even have.
They loved me so much, they killed themselves so that I could get that reaction.
Alright, now where's the brown minion mound? I'm not doing this with fire minions, fuck you, where's the brown minion mound?
Proud. And since this is gonna go up before episode 3 does, I need to start editing that now, but episode 3 is gonna go over the basics of Chris.
Oh shit! Oh, that was bad. And I killed myself. Fuck off.
Congratulations, you just destroyed the sacred grove, and on that point, we're at 25 minutes.
That's fine. I'm aware of what time it is. Calm down. I want this thing and then we'll end this episode.
Okay.
Because that was fucking bullshit.
That was hilarious.
I'm just glad I reset my minions so they don't fucking off themselves in the water. Yeah, it's back here. What the special artifact. Why? Just let me bring my minions. So, once more with feeling.
Proud.
Okay, you all wait over there. Because I don't know how much this Oh, that gave me corruption points.
What have you done?
Oh, okay.
Oh, you killed a unicorn!
Oh, calm down. There were rabies infested. Yeah, you know what? Fuck it. I don't think... Yeah, no, there's no ending for a, there's no ending for a perfect corruption, non-corruption, non-sucking. Actually, can you look that up for me? Because I swear I looked it up before, but now I can't remember.
Alright, just comb your tits.
Because if that's the case, then I fucked up earlier in the LP and I have to basically play this game all over again before the next...
Well, okay, well, don't do anything.
Too late. I've done everything. I don't know what you're talking about.
Okay, apparently there were two endings.
Oh, shit. For you. Oh, wait, two endings? That's fine.
Yeah, I'm assuming that's the good ending and the bad ending.
Yeah, so right now I'm squarely on the path to the good ending. Or, well, the lawful ending, whichever ending that is.
Or they were playing by Bioshock rules and you just fucked yourself over. I guess we'll have to beat the game to find out. The beauty
of I mean, it's either corrupted or not corrupted. I'm already at 6%. I was at 3% earlier. Before we started today, so. No, not through the fuck. I hate you.
So a game I did end up beating was Crash, The Wrath of Cortex. How long has it been since you've played it?
Which game?
Wrath of Cortex.
Wrath of Cortex. Not that long. Like, it's not nearly as good as the PS1 game, but it's still good. Did you seriously off yourself again, you piece of shit?
Blue, greens.
Alright, what did you think of it?
I don't know. Like, I beat it yesterday or 2 days ago.
Oh, you don't? No, please don't. Oh, fuck you.
It felt kind of lifeless to me. It kind of felt like they were just going through the motions of what warped was.
Yeah. I could see how you'd have that reaction. I don't know. Like, yeah, no, it wasn't...
It has not aged... as well as 2 and 3 have.
Yeah. No,
the controls are the controls are surprisingly floaty.
Yeah.
And I don't know how, but it looks kind of ugly.
Well, it's because it's in that weird era where it's between PS1 and PS3. Because you don't get, like, good-looking graphics to a PS3 era, unless you're really artistic about it. Yeah, no, that was that studio's, like, first iteration of Crash. So it doesn't look nearly as good as Twin Sanity, but Twin Sanity isn't complete because the publisher screwed them over.
I don't know, like, there are some exceptions, like... I told you I'm going through Wind Waker, and that game, outside of the camera controls, that game has held up surprisingly well.
Oh yeah, it's because that game is actually good. And, yeah. What's it called? Artistically, it was pretty much what made the cartoonish look. And the GameCube was perfect for it, because Nintendo's always been the weakest platform, performance-wise, but they've always made up for it with fantastic art styles.
Well, the weird thing is, Nintendo, up until the Wii, had some of the most powerful consoles of their generation. The problem was they made really stupid decisions.
Yeah, no, like, technically they're the most powerful, but...
yeah, like, the GameCube was right up there with the original Xbox. The problem was, developers had to find a way to get their game into 1.4 gigabytes.
Yeah, no.
Meanwhile, you had like 8 gigs on the PS2 and Xbox.
Yeah, no, they like I said, they bottlenecked everything for no reason. It was really weird.
And the same thing with the N64. The N64 was the most powerful console of its time, but because it used cartridges, you had to fit everything into, like, 64 megabytes.
Yeah.
It was also... From what I heard, the 64 was actually really hard to develop for as well, to the point where Donkey Kong 64 wouldn't even function without the expansion pack.
Oh, that's weird.
What, you never knew that?
No.
Yeah, that's why they included an expansion pack with every copy of Donkey Kong 64. The game can't run without it. I mean, technically it can, but there is a game-breaking glitch that Rare was never able to fix. So, but it never showed up when the expansion pack was put in. So, in order to make the game beatable, they included an expansion pack with every single copy that was sold of the game.
Hmm. That is weird. Yeah, no, Nintendo's done some weird stuff. Like, the other two console giants have as well, but they weren't nearly as, like, just mind-blowingly dumb as Nintendo.
Yeah.
I mean, except for that PS3 architecture and the Xbox One architecture, which is apparently still confusing devs to this day, although the Xbox One is less of a hassle.
Hell, I would even go farther. I would say the Sega Saturn had the same problem the Xbox One did.